Today we're going to take a look at the best Netflix movies for you to learn Spanish and find out what's great about it. 1. Como caído del cielo.
Dígame la verdad, doctor. ¿Hay alguna posibilidad de que despierte algún día mi Pedro Guadalupe?
Si no fuera por los instrumentos a los que está conectado, moriría inmediatamente.
Pedro Infante, esta es tu oportunidad. O demuestras de una vez por todas que vas al cielo, o te vas al infierno. Ocuparás el cuerpo de un imitador tuyo. Para salvarte, tienes que arreglar en la vida de tu imitador lo que no pudiste arreglar en la tuya.
Me permití prepararle desayuno, señorita.
Tendrás que ser fiel.
Desde que éramos novios no me mirabas así.
¡Qué desperdicio!
After being in limbo for 60 years, the soul of Mexican singer Pedro Infante returns to the land of the living by possessing the body of his impersonator. To get into heaven, he needs to act right by behaving with ladies and staying away from temptations. Otherwise, he'll be sent straight to hell. This film is great if you want to learn Mexican Spanish while having a good laugh. Plus, the peculiarity of this character keeps him talking about his life in the past, present, and future tenses, so you'll get a chance to practice your Spanish verb conjugations too. 2. Vivir dos veces.
Y eso hace que las matemáticas, además de lógica, también sean magia. Eso era Margarita para mí. La magia.
Precioso, papá.
Bueno, seguro que con esto no se te resiste.
A former math teacher is diagnosed with Alzheimer's and moves in with his daughter's family. After they discover his deep desire of reuniting with his childhood crush, they decide to undertake a crazy journey to find her before his memories fade completely. If you want to get exposed to European Spanish, this comedy drama is perfect for you, as the dialect here is easier to understand than in many other Spanish films. Plus, you'll get to learn some current slang, especially from the lovely younger character. 3. La Odisea de los Giles.
Y en un montecito de árboles lo mete ahí adentro y le encarga que haga un agujero de 3 metros por 3 metros por 2 de profundidad. Y cuando Saldaña le pregunta para qué es la pieza, el otro le responde que es para una sala de máquina del filtro de la pileta de la quinta que va a construir. Es ridículo, te puedes imaginar, no puedes empezar por la sala de los filtros, después la pileta y después la quinta.
¿Vos decís?
¿Pero vos sos boludo o te haces? No te das cuenta. Es una bóveda.
To overcome an economic crisis, a group of people joined their savings to launch a project that could ease their situation. Soon after that, a corrupt banker and his lawyer made them lose it all, and they will have to make a plan to recover their money. This adventure comedy is one of the best Argentinian films and a great chance for you to hear the Rioplatense Spanish dialect and its slang. The movie is full of vocabulary-packed dialogues, just like in real Argentinian life, so it will definitely help you improve your conversational Spanish skills. Learning Spanish with films is better than any textbook because it shows you how people really speak. The vocab, the slang, the intonation, and much more. However, you still probably need to pause and leave Netflix several times to check meanings for words that are new to you. And yes, I know, that will be time-consuming. That's why I love watching media on FluentU, because all the movie clips on FluentU come with interactive subtitles, which means I can quickly click on words and expressions to check their meanings on the go and save them on vocab lists to review later. Plus, after I finish watching, I can take a quiz to make sure they stick in my head. Sounds cool, right? If you want to check how quickly and easy it is to learn Spanish with FluentU, click the link below and try it free for 2 weeks. 4. Ya no estoy aquí.
Yo, Jeremy, Chaparra, La Negra y toda la flota, ¿no? Nosotros...
Your friends?
Sí, nosotros somos tercos. Tercos. Así como nosotros, hay muchas otras pandillas. Están, por ejemplo, los Guachalocos, Baby Locos, Duendes, perros gachos, los recaídos, y un chingo, ¿no? Todos somos símbolo estar. Símbolo estar. Y símbolo estar, somos más vergas. Somos vergas, símbolo estar.
Vergas, it's good, right?
Es bueno, sí, es bueno.
Vergas.
A story about migration, friendship and music. Ya No Estoy Aquí follows the journey of the 17-year-old leader of a street gang, passionate about the underculture of cumbia rebajada, a type of slow-down music. After a misunderstanding with a drug cartel, he is forced to leave his hometown in Mexico and move to New York without knowing a word of English. While he fights to keep attached to his identity, you'll not only get to hear Mexican Spanish and its slang, but also learn a lot about the cumbia movement. 5. Soltera codiciada.
¿En serio no me vas a contestar, Matías?
Ala, ala, ala. ¿Eso es lo que crees que merezco después de 6 años de relación?
Bueno, te tengo una primicia, Matías. El tamaño ideal no es ese que tú tienes, ¿ya? El tamaño ideal es otro. ¡Y es grande! ¡Imbécil!
After a breakup, a Peruvian copywriter looks for ways to overcome her heartbreak. Encouraged by her awesome group of friends, she ends up deciding to start writing a blog about relationships and being single. Unexpectedly, it takes off and hilarity ensues. Because Peruvian is often considered the most neutral of all Spanish dialects, this based on a true story flick is ideal for beginner-intermediate learners. Plus, you'll be exposed to vocabulary on all the fun stuff, such as ordering at a bar and going out on dates. 6. Toc toc.
El problema es que lanzo insultos y obscenidades a la gente, pero sin querer. Síndrome de Tourette lo llaman los especialistas.
¿Está de coña?
No, no, no. Le juro que es la verdad. ¡Que te den! Ven, me sale solo.
Ahora que lo dice, creo que vi algo de esto en un documental.
Me pasa desde los 11 años y no saben la cantidad de médicos que he visto. ¡Pelotudo! Perdón.
No, no, tranquilo.
Es que estoy en pleno ataque.
You'll start learning Spanish with this movie from the moment you take its title. Toc Toc is a play on words referring both to the Trastorno Obsesivo Compulsivo, known as OCD in English, and the Spanish translation of the onomatopoeia Knock Knock. In this film, a group of OCD patients wait for their delayed doctor in the same room. The situation turns into a unique group therapy session where everyone interacts with each other's symptoms. This movie includes a lot of vocabulary about health and psychology, and it's another great option if you're more into European Spanish. 7. Ahí te encargo.
Oye, mi amor, ¿qué? Estaba pensando que pues, esa bici se vería muy bonita con una sillita de bebé, ¿no?
Híjole, amor. ¿Qué? Don Gonzalo me ofreció hacerme socia del despacho.
Tú y yo habíamos quedado que algún día íbamos a tener bebé.
Pero no ahorita.
Y justo, yo ahorita tengo tanto trabajo que no tengo tiempo ni para mí.
Alejandro wants to become a father, but his wife, at the highest point of her career, is too busy to have kids. Suddenly, a friend asks him to take care of her own baby for a few days, and Alejandro takes him home. The experience is both hilarious and a real challenge for the couple. The adulthood topics are easy to relate to, making this Mexican movie pretty easy to follow. Along the way, you learn lots of vocabulary on things like career, family, and relationships. 8. Se busca papá.
Solo vine a darte algo, igual y te interesa.
Blanca, seguro tú ganas.
¿Sabes cómo se pondría mi mamá si se entera de que anda en bici?
O sea, no puedes andar en bici, punto.
Son 100,000 pesos.
12-year-old Bianca dreams about becoming a professional BMX cyclist, but her mother, traumatized by her husband's death in a bicycle accident, is not a fan of the idea. When Bianca needs an adult's permission to sign up to a BMX competition, she decides to go in search of an actor that will pretend to be her dad. Another lovely option to get exposed to Mexican Spanish. With this film, you'll learn different types of vocabulary related to biking, acting, and conversational Spanish used between adults and kids. Now, it's time to take your Spanish practice to the next level. In this next video, you'll watch some movie clips and take quizzes to test your listening skills. See you there!